today we're going to be talking about Journeys in Marketing Cloud, which are a really useful tool that anybody who's using Marketing Cloud is probably already familiar with. If you're not, they're basically a very easy and quick way to build customer journeys with marketing communications. You can schedule communications to go out. You can react based on different logic and things. And they really make it a very customized experience for the contacts that you have. One thing that's really useful about journeys in Marketing Cloud is that you can get a history of who's been doing what in the various journeys that you may have set up. So by going to this history tab, you can get information on the different kinds of marketing information that have been going out, whether people have completed, whether contact has been attempted, whether there was any interaction, that kind of thing. One of the limitations, however, is that you can only get the last 30 days of data at most. So if you go to this filter, you can't go any further back than 30 days. While for some journeys that may be fine, and you only need, maybe a few days, a few weeks, or even a month, in theory, you could be losing out on data there. And so what we're going to be talking about today is leveraging an undocumented API to actually collect the journey history for as long as you'd like and store it into a data extension so that you can use that for reporting, especially if you're looking for trending reporting and other historicals of that nature. So that's what we'll be looking at today. So in Marketing Cloud, the first thing that we'll need to do is set up an automation so that we can actually collect that data automatically. We don't want to have to manually do that ourselves. And the best way to do that is with an SSJS script that I have called Retain Journey History here. So the SSJS will call the REST API at the undocumented endpoint, collect the data, and then put it into a data extension that we have defined. I'll go through that really quickly, but I do want to mention here as well that we are checking to see what the storage timestamp is for each of the different business units. In this case, if we had more than one, if there's just one, that's fine. But we want to make sure that we know where we're leaving off. So this last part is this cleanup, just to make sure we know where we're at. So just to very quickly go through some of the different strategies that we've employed to get this data and get this data efficiently. One of the things I'd like to highlight here is the default page size up at the top. We're noting is 1,000. We've tested with a few different page sizes and it seems like 1,000 works the best. You could probably do more than that. However, pushing it up to 2,000 or 3,000 does not seem to work well. And the reason for that is probably because of the amount of data that's coming through that the SSJS is trying to handle. But once we get down into it, if you take a look here, we're just running over each of the different business units. We can kind of skip over some of these functions and go straight into the meat here. We're going to start each function by checking for a start time if we don't have one. We can pass one if we'd like. And we're basically running through and defining a very quick payload, which really is just the start time if you have one. And this is the actual endpoint here, this interaction piece down here. You can specify your search page and the default page size. And that's the really important part. So if we scroll down here, we're of course asking for the things. And the second part I want to go over here is once we get those 1,000 records, what we need to do to make this SSJS friendly is actually parse back over it and compose it into a more rows add friendly JSON list. That's exactly what we're doing here. So we're parsing it out of the JSON we get returned from the REST API and then recomposing it in a way that the rows list is going to like by pushing it into a giant array of row data. And then eventually this is going to get pushed with the rows add function in SSJS. So the strategy is pretty simple once you get the endpoint done. But getting to the endpoint, of course, is the difficult part. You can define a start and end time, and that would be one way to essentially populate your first 30 days of information if you're trying to get more than 10,000 records. So you can get up to 10,000 from an endpoint at a time, and then after that, you're done. So you can manipulate the start and end time at the start if you're trying to get your initial 30 days worth of data. And then for after that, unless you're getting 10,000 lines of data per day, you wouldn't really need to mess with that again. As anyone who's worked with Marketing Cloud knows, the reporting can be one of the most powerful tools that you have. And so being able to capture that journey history can be really important for your organization. If it is and you'd like some help getting that set up, feel free to contact us. We'd be more than happy to help you get that implemented and that reporting set up for your organization.